Hi, I'm Sharon's friend Kate. You're
Samantha. Miss Charles is at dinner.
Sharon told me to drop by. I have this present for Kyle.
And Lisa, by the way.
They sent me away to find them a fortune, a chest filled with diamonds and gold. The house was awake with shadows and monsters. The hallways, they echoed and groaned. I sat alone in bed till the morning. I'm crying, they're coming for me. And I tried to hold these secrets inside me. My mind's like a deadly disease. I'm bigger than my body. I'm colder than this home. I'm meaner than my demons. I'm bigger than these bones.
No, they can't. But you just missed your friend.
What friend?
You know your friend Kate?
I don't know, okay.
She was just here. She had something for Kyle.
Oh my god, where's Kyle?
Around for hours on empty, I jumped at the slightest of sounds. I couldn't stand the person inside me. I turned all the mirrors around.
What are you saying? You've only known her for 2 weeks?
Approximately 2 weeks.
Long enough for her to fantasize that you two were having an affair? What?
No. She came on to me.
Mr. Charles, would you say this affair was...
It was no affair, okay? There was no... affair.
So you're saying she made the whole thing up in her head with no help from you?
That is exactly what I'm saying.
Why do you think she picked you? You should be scared of me.
Who is in control?
Don't you put this all on me, Derek. We both knew what we were getting into from the very beginning.
What?
The first time we met in the elevator. Our dirty martini. The Christmas party. You even said that you wished that you were single so that we could be together.
You don't look happy to see me.
I'm not happy to see you. What are you doing here?
You said that you would never jeopardize your job. That's why I quit, so that we could be together.
You are completely delusional. Do you really believe he's in love with you?
I'm not stealing them, so Monica, I'm not stealing him away. Their marriage is over.
And I've grown familiar with villains that live in my head. They beg me to write them so I'll never die when I'm dead.
This young woman, Lisa Sheridan, she works in your office?
Lisa, the temp? What happened to her?
Yeah, she tried to hurt herself.
Why? What? What did she do?
Mrs. Charles, I'm sorry. And when you rejected her, she tried to commit suicide naked in your bed in your hotel room.
Whoa. She was naked in your bed, Derek?
Ms. She Charles, was naked please. In your hotel room?
Please.
Would you have even told me about this?
Are you crazy? Of course I would have told you.
Yeah, like you told me about the Christmas party, huh? Or what about the parking garage? Yes, she told me about you being in a parking garage with this woman. She was in our house. And now our son is in a hospital bed. I thought you said she was in San Francisco. Why is she back? And how did she even know we'd be out?
This woman is sick, okay? Nothing happened between...
Do I ever ask you? I don't ask you for anything. All I ever asked you was to be honest with me.
I told you the truth. I did.
Lisa, get out of my car now.
Maybe I said something that she took the wrong way.
Like what?
Sharon.
What exactly did you say that she took the
wrong way,
Derek?
I'm gonna have to ask you. She had told the hotel clerk that she was your wife and she wanted to surprise you.
Sharon,
did you have sex with her?
No, I did not.
What's wrong with you?
Why are you acting like a stranger?
That is exactly what I am. A stranger.
One of you better do something about this woman.
Or I will.
Wait, it doesn't touch me.
We can talk.
I told you, don't touch me!
You're sick. You need help.
I know. Help me, Derek.
Stay away from me.
I know how hard it must be to have someone fall out of love with you. I know.